Well, Chris, on the road, here's a look at his latest school visit.
Yeah, I had a road trip. Not myself, but also Allison. We both went to Gertler Elementary to talk with the fourth and fifth graders. I had the opportunity to speak with the fifth graders, and this is the photo that I was able to grab, and they wanted to be movie stars. They said, "What's it like being a movie star, Chris?" I said, "Well, you guys are about to find out tomorrow morning." I said, "Let's get a photo. You want to be on TV, right?" And they all screamed yes. And this was a really, really good group. Here they had lots of great questions. I tested them some on a weather map, asking them to point out lows and highs, cold fronts, and things of that nature. And they really understood it well. So a great group. And I'm glad that I was able to get out there and look forward to my next opportunity to go back out there and speak with some of the kids. Now let's get you into your forecast. Live pinpoint Doppler as we scan the skies this morning, tracking more scattered snow showers. And they are pesky in nature. And they're finally going to taper off later on this morning and into the first part of your afternoon. Now, temperatures, a big concern this morning because we're at or just below freezing as the snow continues to fall. With the colder temperatures below freezing in some spots, that's going to allow the snow to actually stick on the roadways, unlike much of yesterday where we had ongoing hit-and-miss snow showers, but temperatures were above freezing, so a lot of that didn't stick to the roadways. Different story this morning, so we got some slick spots out there. Just watch out for that. As you're getting the kids ready for the bus stop forecast this morning, temperatures around 30 degrees, so it's a cold one. Be sure to bundle them up, extra layers. The winter coat will be ideal, not only for this morning, but later on this afternoon as well, as temperatures eventually climb into the upper 30s later on this afternoon, and we could see a few rays of sunshine, but mostly cloudy skies do prevail. More sunshine, though, expected for your Saturday and Sunday, and it's going to be a nice weekend. Now, here's a look at the latest satellite and radar imagery as we loop over the past 6 hours, still catching some moisture off the Great Lakes region. That's providing some of the development we're seeing for those scattered snow showers, but I promise things are going to get better, eventually going to taper off by early afternoon. Unfortunately, the cloud cover will stick around, and that's exactly what Future View shows through this afternoon into tonight and by early Saturday morning, still fighting some clouds out there, but look what happens by Saturday mid-afternoon. Lots of sunshine for all of central and eastern Kentucky. That will stick around through Saturday night as we'll go mostly clear and then plenty of sunshine expected as we wrap up your weekend. And even better, check out these temperatures Saturday and Sunday. 50 degrees for a high tomorrow afternoon as we clear things out. Plenty of sunshine expected into Sunday. And yes, your eyes are not deceiving you, folks. 64 as we head into Sunday afternoon. Get out and enjoy it if you can. A few showers possible. We're talking late Sunday, early Monday, so your day looks really, really nice. More showers expected into early to next midweek, but temperatures remain on the mild side with highs in the upper 50s and lower 60s. Let's get that fourth and final check of the refrigerator art this morning. See what we have behind the magnets. Love showcasing all the wonderful artwork from the kids here across eastern Kentucky. A nice photo sent in from Ben over at May Valley Elementary. Time now, 6:42. You're watching Mountain News This Morning right here on WYMT.